education. So Barbara and I took on a big venture designing and teaching an interdisciplinary course together. And we came up with this course that we had these two essential questions we wanted to answer at the beginning of the process. Do cultural understandings of race and gender influence how science is done? Do scientific results and or the interpretation of those results change our cultural understandings of race and gender?
And we wanted this to be a lab course because, as one of the questions says, talks about how science is done. We thought it would be more beneficial for the students to actually be in the lab and do some science as they're integrating across these two fields. And this was really the driver of our collaboration. We found that we both really loved this book for very different reasons. As a cell biologist, I loved the story of how the first human cell line was established, where it came from, and how it was used for medical advances, pharmacological advances, biological advances.
And I was struck by the text because I saw it as another text that talked about discrimination in regards to marginalized groups, particularly Black, poor women. And I wanted to know more about that. I wanted to know more about the science part. And Barbara wanted to know more about the cultural part.
So the point of this slide right here is that this was...
that's unfolding in front of you.
A very, very long process.
Very long.
And starting pre-2010, with our NSF advance grant with Skidmore, that's called the Sun Grant, where I got to learn about what Deidre does.
And I got to learn what Barbara does. We wouldn't have known that because we're coming from two different divisions across the college.
We had both formal and informal interactions. We had, we both did the FDI in two different times. We put in a CHAS grant that wasn't funded, and Dean McCarty gave us wonderful encouragement to say there might be some things coming down the pike, keep this idea alive. And so with that, we decided that in the fall of 2015, my upper level cancer cell bio class and
my intro to Africana studies class would join together.
We assigned the book and we had a joint book discussion for an evening.
And my Africana studies class went to the lab and so I got a little exposure
to
cell culture.
And so we thought, we could do this. So when a Mosh grant opportunity came up, we just said, we're going to develop a course.
You can go for it.
And that's when the real fun began and the hard work, and as you can see. But we did eventually run the course in winter of 2018, and now we are planning to teach it again in winter of 2020.
Yes.
So again, this was the impetus for starting the course, but we now had to embark on learning each other's fields, and not only learning each other's fields, but learning in our own fields. I never taught a gen ed science course before. I don't teach human genetics, right. Never have.
And I don't know how to pipette, so it was a good, good exchange.
What do I know about the evolution of Homo sapiens, right?
Right.
So this was...
These are some of the texts that we read over and read multiple times to try to dissect and figure out what do we want to learn and how do we want to teach these students who are going to embark on this journey with us.
And I had to then, once we culled it out, we had so many ideas. And we got wonderful feedback from faculty. Oh, have you seen this? Have you seen that? I had to find labs that would support or emphasize the points that we wanted to make. So it was a long process. So this is how we thought it would work, right? I am the biologist.
I'm the sociologist.
And we would expose students to these wonderful things, and they would integrate across
would
the discipline seamlessly.
Seamlessly.
Yes. Flow. How naive, right?
How naive.
Anyway, and so when we started the course, we realized something else.
No, it doesn't work. We were as vulnerable as the students were who decided to take this course. We had to question and reformat where we were taking the journey with the students.
We had to make those connections for them, but you know, also for us. And so now that we're planning the course again, we've given it a lot of thought, and we decided that we need to stay here in the middle ground, here where we're not expert at all, and to carry through for this next iteration some three major themes. What's the basis for genetic differences, genetic similarities? How is genetics used in today's society?
Bioethically, what are the questions we should be asking? Should we question the scientists and how they create research studies and create the information that we are questioning and trying to find out more about? And we explored Afrofuturism. Afrofuturism is this way of looking at the history and the future reimaginings of Black bodies in worlds, contemporary worlds, and in the future. And based on that Henrietta Lacks story, we realized that she was our foremost Afrofuturist. Her cells are in the now, in the present. Even though what happened in the past was egregious to her, there's been platforms to shift and change that. So how does that story inform us in regards to how science can be seen in a cultural lens that's more equitable?
And of course we have
questions.
You know, more other questions. Something else might strike us that we might want to do as well. So did it work? The students seem to appreciate the opportunity to be in the lab. They analyzed a portion of their own DNA to look at their evolutionary haplogroup, and it was fun.
It was fun.
They did amazing end-of-term projects, and
we even had one graduate of the class who ends up now being a physics teacher in a public school in Boston, who was a soc major and used this class as saying, I feel authoritative in science that I can teach in this area.
Not afraid of lab science.
At all.
At all. And what did we learn?
We had to learn to unlearn. We had to learn to relearn. And it's an ongoing process with constant communication and ongoing support from the institution.
We had to be comfortable being uncomfortable, and that's probably going to be for every time we teach it.
Teach and meet to talk about it.
Yeah. Not to make assumptions.
And really be flexible with our course design the next go around.
And this is, as I think Deidre said it best when we were planning this, this is really a tale of what institutional support can do. Because without the institutional support, I don't think I'd be brave enough to to do this. And the wonderful creative ideas we get from across campus, also the granting agencies, the chairs, the people who have contributed to the course, it's been absolutely remarkable. So thank you all.
Thank you very much.